What? No, we don't offer tombside pickup. This is a virtual library. You're thinking of real libraries like Mount Pleasant Public Library that's offering curbside pickup now. Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. You shouldn't really sneak up on people like that. But since you're here, let me tell you about my reading experience with an author named Dean Koontz. I would always see Dean Koontz right next to Stephen King in the horror section of the bookstore. And in most fiction sections of libraries, I would somehow lump them together in my mind, most likely because their last names both begin with K, and their books appear close together, but also they came into the horror fiction scene about the same time, with Dean Koontz making his name for himself 6 years after King's first successful novel, Carrie, was published. They're also around the same age, prolific writers, and tend to write best-selling horror-themed novels, and have had their work adapted to film from time to time. So there's that as well. The similarities really end there, though. While King may have more of a mass appeal, I find Koontz's work a little more eclectic and interesting, especially in terms of plots and themes. As I've said before, Dean Koontz is a very prolific writer, and I have barely scratched the surface of his writing. I'll tell you which novels that I've read and which I've enjoyed. Links for the novels available digitally will be listed below, but now that Mount Pleasant Library is offering a curbside pickup at the time of this recording, you can also place a hold on the physical book and pick it up at the library if you like. I will leave a general link to the catalog below as well. Recently, PBS aired a program called The Great American Read, and Koontz's novel The Watchers ranked in the top 100 of their novels. Watchers is about a government experiment to make super intelligent golden retrievers and controllable genetically engineered creatures for tactical military combat. When the golden retriever escapes from the lab, a fellow named Travis, a name perhaps lifted from the main character of Old Yeller, finds him and takes him in. But the creature paired with the retriever has also escaped and is out to wreak havoc as well as kill the golden retriever and anyone associated with him. This in turn brings the government after Travis, who decides to take his special new dog and newlywed wife on the run. Travis's attempt to hide from the government also brings him to the attention of the mafia, who sent an assassin after him. The assassin is quite a character as well, as he has the delusional belief that he can absorb the souls of his victims. There are some other story elements that I've left out, but it's quite a hodgepodge already. You can see what I mean by eclectic. One of Koontz's most popular series in recent years is Odd Thomas. These novels are set in California's Mojave Desert, perhaps intended to be a bit of a parody or a slight on the movie The Sixth Sense. The main character, named nicknamed Odd Thomas, is a young man that sees dead people, but he doesn't just see them, he does something to help them. Not only does he see dead people, but he also sees other creatures invisible to everyone else that appear to feed on human suffering, which he refers to as Bodocs. When many of the creatures appear, Odd Thomas is alerted that something in that area bad will happen. He is also haunted by, at least in the first three novels, a mute apparition of the late Elvis Presley, who he knows he has to help make it into the afterlife, but he's not quite sure what to do. While the second novel, Forever Odd, has no paranormal happenings outside the Bodocs, apparitions of Elvis, the third novel, Brother Odd, features a mystery with an explanation that owes more to science fiction than the paranormal, and the whole plot is reminiscent of an episode of Scooby-Doo where the villain would have gotten away with it if it wasn't for that pesky Odd Thomas. A streaming movie of the first novel, Odd Thomas, is available on Hoopla Digital. And now on to my favorites. The Bad Place is a wild ride. A private investigation firm is approached by a man suffering from amnesia who is in fear of his life, and he's being pursued by a superhuman stalker. The stalker is a large, hulking man that has the ability to kill using projections of psychic energy, kind of like Goku from Dragon Ball Z. The reader also learns that twin girls with the psychic ability to control animals are also in pursuit of the man with amnesia. It turns out that the man with amnesia, his pursuers, are part of the same crazy family, and their origin story is probably the most horrific part of the novel. After the amnesia victim regains some of his memory, it turns out that he has the most outlandish psychic power, and the reader learns why he is so coveted by his family, and they want him back. And my all-time favorite is Phantoms, which perhaps took partial inspiration from the movie Kaltiki the Immortal Monster, and the legend of the mysterious disappearance of inhabitants of an ancient Mayan city. When a college student and her sister return to their remote rural hometown for Christmas break, they find it totally deserted and strange paranormal happenings going on. Things get weirder and weirder, and they stumble upon a message from a couple of banished tourists, which tells them to find Dr. Flight. It turns out that Dr. Flight is an expert on mass disappearances, which have happened quite a bit all over the world throughout history, and will help them figure out the cause behind them. It is another wild ride. A movie starring Ben Affleck, which was made several years ago, but doesn't do the book justice. As usual, the book is almost always better than the movie. Well, that's all I have read from Dean Koontz, and I certainly want to check out more of his work. And I hope I'll see you next time. And may all your scares be safe ones. Bye.